Hello everyone, it's great to see you all again. Today, I will show you how to create custom P and ID line types in AutoCAD Plant 3D. Let's get started. First, navigate to the project folder. Find the projsymbolstyle.dwg file and open it. In the command line, type LTYPE or LT and hit enter. In the line, type manager dialog, click the load button. A load and reload line types dialog will appear with AutoCAD.line already selected. Search for the desired line type and select it. If you can't find the line type you need, click the File button, browse and select the AutoCAD ISO.line file and click Open. Again, search for the line type you want and select it. Click OK. Note: if the line type you need is still unavailable, you will have to create a new one. The newly selected line type will appear in the Line Type Manager dialog box. To create a multi-line style line type, type ML style in the command line and hit enter. Here, you can either modify the existing standard style or create a new one. For demonstration, I will create a new one. Click the new button, then enter a new style name, such as custom multiline. Click continue. Provide a description for your custom multiline type. In the elements section, you will see two default line types listed with values of plus 0.5 and minus 0.5. The plus 0.5 indicates the top line of the multiline, while the minus 0.5 indicates the bottom line. Select the line you want to change and click the line type button. Search for the desired line type and select it. If you still can't find the line type, click the file button, choose the AutoCAD ISO.lin file and click open. Once more, search for the line type you want and select it. Click OK. You can customize your multiline type by adjusting various settings, such as increasing the offset distance, changing the default line color, fill color, or adding one more line to the multiline type by clicking the Add button as you prefer. Once you finish, click OK. If you have an existing multiline styles.mln file, load it by clicking the Load button in the Multiline Style dialog box. Then, click the File button, browse for your multiline styles.mln file, and click Open. Select the desired multiline style and click OK. Click OK again to save your settings. You can also create a new layer for each custom P and ID line type if needed. Next, open the project setup and go to P and ID DWG settings, P and ID class definitions, engineering items, lines, pipeline segments. Right-click on the pipeline segments node and choose New from the context menu. In the Create Class dialog, enter the class name and display name as shown in the video. Remember, spaces and symbols are not allowed in the class name, but they are permitted in the display name. After creating the class, click the Edit Line button. If you want to display process lines as a single line in the P&ID, set the line type to polyline and select the newly added line type from the drop-down in the Line Settings dialog. To show process lines as a double line in the P and ID for steam tracing, electric tracing, or jacketed lines, then set the line type to M-line and choose the new M-line style from the drop-down in the Line Settings dialog. Keep the other settings as shown in the video. Click OK. To add the new line type to the P and ID tool palette, click the Add to Tool Palette button. Click OK to save your settings and exit the project setup. You can now create a new P and ID drawing or open an existing one to root and test the new line type. That's all for today's episode. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Make sure to hit that bell icon, so you never miss an update on latest videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time.